Welcome to Chunner Studio. My name is Chunner. I'm New York City Ballet's principal.
Oh my god!
And this is Harper Water, first soloist with Houston Ballet.
Hello, how are you? Good to see you again. It's 2022.
Oh my god, we are old.
And we're in New York. Okay. And Chunner has someone literally filming for him. He's a principal at New York City Ballet.
And I'm very lucky we have an intern.
And I'm still single.
Not a lot has changed for me.
No, a lot's changed.
Yes. How have you been? What have you been doing during the pandemic?
Oh, we're starting there. I found TikTok.
Okay.
Love TikTok. Follow me on TikTok.
Yes.
I'm on your channel asking for followers. How the roles have switched again. Oh my god.
Oh well.
Usually it's the other way around. Okay, I found TikTok. And then once we got back to work, I'm like skipping really fast, obviously, but once we got back to work, I found like a new, I feel like I had a new passion for dance. I feel like I was really motivated to get back in the studio, probably because I hadn't danced for a really long time.
Oh, you have been dancing only in the kitchen.
Yeah, hold on. And yeah, I just was really ready to work, and so I felt like I had a good mindset, and I was super, super focused, and a lot of roles were coming my way, and so I was like, maybe there is some sort of promotion or something career-wise that I can achieve. I started the pandemic as a soloist, and now I'm a first soloist, and so I feel like some TikTok and my work ethic got me promoted. That promotion was really exciting for me.
So what was the work ethic? Was the difference between when you were before the soloist? And what was reached before you get promoted?
I think that before the pandemic, I was working really hard. But I just think I worked harder when I got back because the pandemic was like, you don't know how much time you have.
Right.
You know, and our career as dancers is already shorter than so I just was like, I feel like I don't have a lot of time. And so I think I really, not like in an intense way, I just was like, hello. But I felt like it was I feel like more focused. Like I went like super butthead.
Yeah, I do feel the same feeling like after the pandemic. Literally, I see every performance like my last. It's because you don't know if tomorrow if you are going to keep performing or you're going to stop, like how we stop.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I'm like, yeah, so I felt sorry to those like students or apprentices who just got into the company, you know, during this time.
Yeah.
Because we are the people who keep saying we have the faith of dance and we keep going. But a lot of people, if you were like apprentice during those time, we would be going.
I know. It really made it so that they had to like, I was really impressed by the younger students because they kept up their training in their house.
Yes.
Over Zoom. And I don't know if I could have done that when I was 16, 17, 18. It would have been really, really difficult. But getting back and just finishing a season and having the young dancers in the company see how good they are, it inspires me.
Okay. And obviously, like during this time, everyone have got COVID at least once. Have you got it?
I have had COVID.
And how did you? Yes. And how did you have, you know, mentally stable and able to come back? You know, I had to, but I was able to keep myself like calm and keep working, prepared, knowing that I've been wrong.
Yeah, I think that not to get so political or like whatever, but I feel like especially with COVID,
not political at all.
There was something that I just felt like there was like a pressure. Like it was like if you got it, you didn't want to say you got it, but there was like embarrassment, or there was like something like you're a bad person if you have it. Or it's like something like you live a reckless life, and maybe that's just me or like what I felt.
That's why you never find out until now.
But so I feel like. I got it much later, technically. You know, like when first we were in quarantine, never had it. And then there was that point, like in July last year, where you didn't have to wear masks. didn't get it then, didn't get it in December during Nutcracker, people were like, I remember our company was a little crazy because people were getting it and we were like, are we going to do shows and whatnot? And so I was nervous. I was like, I don't want to get it. But it's just a sickness, and I'm lucky to be healthy, and I'm lucky that I got vaccinated and boosted. So when it was my time a few weeks ago to get it, I just, it wasn't as intense as other people had it. But I felt really bad. I felt like I let my company down a little bit because people had to dance my roles and they had to make casting changes. So I felt bad for that reason, but I'm not embarrassed that I got it because I think it's inevitable now.
Right.
And, but I didn't have many major symptoms and I was able to come back.
That's true.
I was able to come back and finish the second weekend of our shows. And I'm so very lucky.
Interesting, like when I got it, I know I have jumped in for some shows for people who just got it.
Yeah.
And so I was pretty calm, and knowing that I have to come back in 2 weeks, and I have like been prepared to go in again.
Yeah.
So I was taking class, I've been taking class at home, and then trying to eat as much as protein as possible to keep myself strong. Because one of my friends was telling me that why the COVID protein is something that you can help to get better muscle. Thank you. And so, so literally right after I come back from COVID, I had to jump in for someone who got injured, and then I had to learn a ballet in 1 hour. And without eating so much protein, I won't be able to do it. Because 2 days ago, I was like laying in bed, and then 3 days later, after that, a lot. But like, how did you, were you okay being throwing in, like, going to the end of the season? I know people getting injured and then COVID, you pick up a lot of stuff, right?
I picked up a lot of stuff. Not as much as the younger dancers in our company. Like, we have people learning roles day on the show. They're like superheroes for that. But a part of me was like, that's so impressive and so amazing and I'm so proud of them. But I also was like, I think that this is going to make them stronger dancers because I had to do that. A lot of us who are older dancers or more seasoned dancers have been in situations where you have to learn things really, really fast. And it's about, it's an opportunity to prove yourself. You can be reliable. You know, once you get into everyone's a good dancer. Everyone is so strong. Everyone has amazing technique. And you have to find ways to sort of separate yourself. That isn't just the dance. And so I feel like to prove that you can learn choreography really fast and still do it well and still act and tell a story and or be a, you know, live your life on stage is a really impressive skill. And it's ways of sometimes you don't know when your opportunities are going to happen. When you're younger in the company, and I personally was usually a second cast or a third cast, or I never even learned the ballet. And my opportunities would come if someone got hurt or we needed someone, and I was like, okay, well, this is my time to shine. And so I feel like I relied on that, on those skills.
Right.
So when I came back from COVID and something happened, you know, and I could get thrown in, I was confident that I could do it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was really impressed with the dancers who let them jump in, but also I think that it will make them
right. And most of the time when I get three and I'm knowing which spot I'm going to learn, I already do some of the work before the rehearsal.
Yeah.
And really focus on at the moment, like what you're going to learn, and try to learn, because you don't have time to really digest it and then do it with your body. You have to do it the next day or in a couple hours later. So you have to try to start to run the ballet literally,
yeah.
And focus on the stuff that you could not remember, and then you're like, okay, that was the step I did not remember. So that's how you became quicker and the faster. And how I know it is so important and so meaningful to us to jump in for something.
Mm-hmm.
And how do you make it good because you want it to do well? How do you tell yourself, how do you learn, how do you prepare for it?
It's hard because I feel like I would look back at some of like maybe I just managed, like I didn't, it wasn't as like amazing as I thought. But I feel like it's just everything in every role, every class is like a learning process. It's a step in the like, to be better. And so it's not, nothing's gonna happen overnight. You have to like be present and be in the moment. And I think that that's one thing I'm really learning right now is that to be present on stage and not, I mean, you can practice in the studio to be really great, to do it as best as you want, but really being present and living in the moment and taking whatever happens on stage as, you know, what's happening is a really beautiful thing and something that I think makes it so you're not just going out there and doing sets.
Right.
And so I try to remind myself that, and I just try to be, you know, I started this because I love it, and I'm not to go out there and feel like I'm taking the SATs or like taking a test. And so, and just figuring out. Also, if you get thrown in, they need you. You don't need them.
Yeah.
So, like, you're helping. So you're helping save the ballet. You're helping.
And you're
going on.
You're going to do whatever you want.
Yes. So it's like the mindset of they need you. Also, the
amazing. So
oh, this is it?
It's not. Thank you so much for sharing your experience. Okay. See you next time. Oh, no. Like, I was gonna ask you.
Sorry.
There's some video that you have done. I wonder if you have anything that I can watch. So, it's like a video reaction. Like, a watch. So during the pandemic, we have done a lot of portrait and videos. So I want to watch one of your video here.
Got it.
And see how we are. Also, I want to see your reaction too. And then I will show one of my video.
And I react to it.
React as crazy as Japanese.
That's easy. Easy. Wait, okay. I don't know the video.
I don't think
you're going to pick the video of me.
No, I'm going to pick the video of mine. You're going to pick the video of yours.
Oh, I do? Okay.
Okay. Do you have a video of yours? Yours first.
Are you serious? I hope you're feeling this. You wanna
yes, oh, your horse.
I feel like you've seen all of these.
Well, I wanna brag again in front of people.
Oh, I got a good one. Like, a short video.
How long do you want me to react?
I don't know. Well, how long are you gonna dance?
It would be 2 minutes.
That's both of us!
Okay, then 1 minute. I do it 1 minute one.
That's not long, it's just like, you know.
Have you seen my sassy girlfriend? Is it sassy girlfriend? It's a ballet.
Sassy girlfriend?
Yeah. I know it's not anxious. So maybe I'll show you this one. It's with the, not the dance. It's a brand that I collaborate with.
Then you have never shared this.
I don't think so. Have you seen this?
No, it's not. No, start it. It's real. Just let me. That's okay. Let's just do it.
But no, it's not.
But you should be very proud of that. So
we need to hire more dancers
for commercials. Real dancers.
Yeah. You ready? So this is about the bird.
Another bird.
So commercially, we're talking about this bird. Like, where is my inspiration coming from? And we, I'm also talking about the bird with the freedom of flying, and I never rest. I just keep flying, and that's how my inspiration comes from. And then the last thing about my work is story.
Emotion.
Yeah.
Were you nervous?
I was not. Oh, kind of. It's just like a journey. I cannot fail.
You go.
Lovely.
Thank you.
Lovely.
Great technique.
That's fine. It's very, that's your awkward face.
Normally that's the end of the solo, but then I had to Serena comes out and
wow. That's beautiful.
Thank you so much.
So how many shows have you done in depth?
We did
nine shows this long. Oh well.
Should we wrap that up?
Yeah, we should. So
where are we right now?
We are in the downtown New York Manhattan, and it's a studio called Battery Studio.
So why are we in the studio?
Because I rent it.
For what?
Well, I'm teaching my Chunner Studio in-person class. Yeah, you should take a class today.
I'm on vacation.
Okay.
But you are sitting on the list. It's like a whole summer intensive.
Yeah, I am. I did. And thanks to all the my students, they organize everything and they help me a lot. So I'm just showing up and teach. Like, I don't have too much. No, it's just what you think.
But
they made it very easy.
But that is a really big undertaking to say I'm going to put together a program for people. That's a lot of moving parts.
Yeah. Well, I have done a lot of masterclass, some intensive in China after the TV show. All the dance school they asked me. So I know like what's the certificate I need to prepare, autograph, pictures, time to speak, time to begin and wrap up. And it's like everything that I have experienced when I was in China.
You think it's like, I find it inspiring.
Thank you.
You didn't let me finish.
Okay.
No, what I was going to say, I find it inspiring because how long have I been here?
10 years. You talk 12 years.
10, 12 years. And when we met, you didn't speak barely any English. But it lived a girl. You're now a principal of New York City Ballet. And when we were at least in ballet together, you just started a YouTube channel that was called Chunner Studio.
Yeah.
Where you just were talking to the camera, giving little bits and pieces to people, hoping that people watch and like follow. And now you've built
an empire.
I don't know about an empire. Because you built that, and I mean, I literally walked in the back of this Chunner Studio.
Yeah.
Like you're making a brand, and it's amazing to see growth like that happen over time. And look at you, showed me a video of you dancing in an international TV show.
Right.
And you can even speak English as a girl.
I know, like, it's interesting for me to go into an area that I don't know and I start to learn after I leave the environment. Same thing from Bangladesh to Bangladesh. I did not speak Bangladesh language so much, but once I be in the New York City Ballet, I already learned. And, you know, everyone speaks the same language. So it's actually, it is a lot of pressure,
yeah.
But it's same as the language.
Yeah.
But it's, I improve much faster. And so I like that feeling of keep improving myself and learning stuff. And also like seeing a lot of my followers on YouTube and Instagram, they were like, oh, you got the channel. And I have to watch your video and you changed my life. It's like, he was dancing Chinese folk dance, and then because of the Chinese studio, he started to change his career actually.
Oh, wow.
And he just got into Washington Ballet. And Judy, she hired him. And he was learning all the Chinese studio skill and technique.
So we are sitting on this.
So, well, thank you so much for...
Wow, nothing about my career?
Yes, of course.
So we're going to wrap up. I've done nothing in the years that I've been
chugging. And literally the other day. No, I want to talk about this. She's like, stop. No, like the other day, because of the free show, how I've done, people know me from there. And it's like, I have so much fun being comfortable in front of camera through the show. He did. And now, I don't know how much I can say, but he's have so much exciting things coming up, so please follow up and follow his Instagram, follow his YouTube, follow his TikTok. He is the social media guru, the Harper. Also, thank you so much for people who have been supporting me in the Patreon. Without your help, I can't do all of this. And yes, and I'm almost, you know, start to really have a plan for my Chunner Studio and post regularly because I haven't posted for 2 years, especially educational video, so I'm gonna get off that. Oh, and also my chunweichun.com website is coming soon, so you can find all my platform and stuff and my upcoming shows and all the articles that have been posted. You will be there. So turn on.
Yesterday, right? You turn on. Chunner, you turn on. Anyway, please comment if you have any question. Follow and subscribe.
And like.
Yeah, thank you.
Share.
And share. Here we go. Oh, so much. Thank you. Dude. I'm gonna keep you busy. Thank you so much for showing. I will see you in Harper, the pre-show maybe. See you.